With a little practice, you will be able to do it. And if you master this, you will be astonished over the results you will get. Hello and welcome. Today I'm showing you how to paint a Mordor Troll step by step. The miniature is sprayed with a cenotal highlight of grey sear over a black undercoat. The video has four parts: base coating, wash, basing, and highlight. The first paint I use is Gilliman Flesh. This will be used on every part of the skin. Make sure to hit the calluses on the back and thighs, as this color sets the stage for the next in these areas. The next color I use is Nazrag Yellow. Now it's just a case of hitting all the cloth parts of the miniature. This will be the loincloth, the shoulders, hands, and arms. You can choose other colors here if you want your troll to match a specific army. I just go for yellow here, because I want to use this troll in multiple armies, and I like the beaten up, dirty look of this color. Then I move over to Black Templar. This is just to paint in the straps, belts, and the shaft of the Warhammer. I use Lead Belcher next, and this is used to paint in all the metal. That is the belt buckle, chest plate if you used it, helm, Warhammer, arm guards, and the little ring on the back that holds the straps in place. Now I move over to Gore Grunta Fur to further darken the hardened skin on its back and thighs. Here you need to be extra careful not to hit too far out on the skin, as this will take some time to fix if you do. Next I use Volupus Pink. This is just to be used in the mouth of the troll. Be sure to hit all the gums and cover the teeth as well, as this will give a nice effect when we paint them later. I then use Abaddon Black to paint in the toenails and fingernails. Now that the base coating is done, I move over to the wash phase. And now it's just a case of covering the entire model with Agrax Earthshade. This will make the miniature go from incredibly ugly to okay looking. This is because the shade darkens the model and creates a nice shadow in the recesses. It also makes the transition between different colors smoother and gives the miniature a more natural look. While this is drying, I usually get started on the base. I want the base to match the rest of my army, so I start with Stirland Mud. I find it easier to start in the middle and work my way outward. When this is dry, I'm dry brushing with Carrick Stone and then a lighter dry brush with Wraithbone. I will complete the base at the end of this video. I will now start with the highlight phase, and the first color I will use is Bugman's Glow. This is the first of three highlights for the skin. Do not hit the hardened skin with this, as it will be getting a different highlight. Because of the loose, old, and cracked skin on the troll, I am painting little horizontal lines all over the skin. Make sure to leave a little room between the skin and other areas of the model, so that you don't lose the shadow effect from the shading from earlier. It is also a good idea to leave the shadow in the deepest recesses of the skin. Congratulations, the troll now has a nasty sunburn. To make the skin paler again, I use Cadian Flesh Tone. Using the same technique as with the previous layer, I'm hitting a smaller area. Be sure to thin your paint so that some areas are more transparent. In this case, less is more. It's better to paint another layer with this color than to paint on too thick. The color should be less transparent in the places where the light naturally hits the model. For the last highlight on the skin, I use Kislev Flesh. And now it's just a case of using the same technique as before, but hitting an even smaller area. I will show you a little trick on the face. If you paint vertical lines on the bottom lip and the area over the mouth, with one line on each side like this, the face will look really good. This is an incredibly fun way to paint skin. I enjoyed it a lot. It's not a beginner technique, but it's not too hard either. With a little practice, you will be able to do it. And if you master this, you will be astonished over the results you will get. Okay, so let's do something about the calluses. Mournfang brown is the color of choice. This is a very easy step, and I just paint the very top of the calluses one by one. Next, I use Talarn sand to highlight the cloth. Just paint in the edges, not too far down, as we want some shadow where the light is not as dominant. Corvus black was then used to highlight the shaft of the warhammer, straps and the belts. Now back to lead belcher. As I want the armor to look beaten and dark, I don't want to use a brighter metallic color than this. Because of the shading from earlier, it will still give a nice highlight. When applying, I'm not being too careful, as this will give the impression of a weathered look. Mephiston red is used to paint in the eyes. Next, I use Rhinox hide. If you want, you can leave the finger and toenails like they are. I decided to give this miniature some extra love. Apply the paint in small lines, moving from the base of the nail and out towards the tip. This will make it so the black will show in between the lines a little bit. I then use Mournfang brown in the same way, so that the rhinox hide are showing in between. The next color is Talarn sand, and I do just the same thing as before. And then I use Screaming Skull as the final highlight in the same way. This is where I also paint in the teeth. Be careful not to hit the gums or tongue. To finish off the base, I painted the rim black and put a couple of grass tufts on there. And now the miniature is complete, ready to crack open some Gondorian skulls. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, consider subscribing to the channel for more content like this. Please like the video if you found it entertaining or informative, and leave a comment down below if you have any questions. Have a nice day.